Good morning, my dear student. Today we are going to learn a third problem on the naval ship. Okay. The motor of a marine having a mass of 1000 kg and the radius of gyration is 300 mm rotate at 1550 rpm clockwise when looking from the bow. Determine the gyroscopic couple and its effect on the ship in the following cases. So first case is when the ship pitch with the angular velocity of 1 radian per second when bow is rising and falling. First condition. And second condition is given when the ship is speeding with a velocity of 40 km per hour and take a right turn in a circular path of 200 mm radius. And third one we are going to learn about when the ship is roll at certain with the angular velocity of 0.5 radian per second when it is seen from the rear end. First one we are going to learn about when the ship pitches with angular velocity of 1 radian per second when bow is rising as well as when the bow is falling. Okay. So this axis we know very well, this axis we know as axis of spin, horizontal axis we can say as axis of spin. Okay, axis of spin, the vertical axis is known as axis of precession. Okay. The rear end we can say as stern, the front end we can say as bow. Okay, then if ship is pitching upward as well as when ship is falling down. Okay, here let us see, that is the front view of a figure. Then same axis of spin, axis of precession, rear end we can say as stern and front end we can say as bow. But remember here, he's telling that a marine ship is having a mass of how much is there? 1000 kg. The marine of a motor is having a mass of how much? 1000 kg. Mass equal to 1000 kg. And the radius of gyration is given as K equal to 300 mm. Okay. Rotate at 1550 rpm. So this means that the rotor is rotating of a speed is 1550 rpm clockwise when looking from the bow. So this means that the observer is observed from the where here the observer is observed from the bow to the marine ship. This rotor is rotating in clockwise direction when it is seen from the bow. Okay, here. Then actually we in this case only three cases is given. The first is pitching effect we need to find out. The second cases is given of turning moment toward left turn or right turn, and third one rolling effect we need to find out. The first one we have to go for pitching effect. Is it right? In the pitching, we need to find out the gyroscopic couple. But before the finding the gyroscopic couple, we have to know about which type of the force or which type of the effect is acting on this ship. Is it right? Let us see. I will explain here only. Okay. When bow is rising, this bow is rising. Bow rising. It indicates this bow is rising. If it is moved down, what they indicate? The bow is falling. Is it right? It's indicated as bow falling. Then, actually, we need to know about the effect on the pitching. I will represent here effect. During the pitching, we need to know. Let us see, if you draw the vector diagram of this figure, the observer is here. They observe to the ship from the bow. Is it right? I am representing here. That is the origin point, O, O. From here to here, O to X, it is represented as O2X. O2X we can say as angular momentum, or we can say as initial angular momentum before taking turn, or it may be before pitching. Okay, here O2X. Is it right? If the rotor is rotating in clockwise direction, we are talking about bow is rising. The first condition is pitching in which bow rising. Okay, the bow is rising. The observer is observed from the bow O2X. It is moved. The O X to X dash we can say as reactive gyroscopic couple. Okay, and the reactive gyroscopic couple, this one X to X dash we can say as active gyroscopic couple, and X to X dash we can say as reactive gyroscopic couple. This reactive gyroscopic couple always act opposite direction of active gyroscopic couple. Then the couple is acting in a horizontal plane. First you have to know about this couple is acting, which direction here? This couple is acting in a horizontal plane. The couple is acting in a horizontal plane. Okay, the couple is acting in a horizontal plane and turned to, this bow is turned to raising toward. So above, what we can say here, this above left hand side of a stern we can say as port, right hand side of a stern we can say as starboard. If bow is rising, so this means that it tend to turn toward the port. So this means that they move toward the left hand side, we can say. Okay dear, and tend to turn toward the port.
That is, we can say as left side. We can say.
So that is the bow rising. Is it right? If it is bow falling down, then what will happen? Let us see. Pitching effect in which we are going to discuss about bow is falling down.
Bow is falling.
Okay, dear. Then let us see. If the bow is falling, then what will happen? I will change this chalk piece. That is, the observer is observed from the bow. It is represented as O, and the initial angular momentum, it is represented as X. Is it right? So how is it here? So actually, we want this bow is falling down. If the bow is falling down, means that is O X. They're taking the, they're moving upward direction. So X2 X dash, what we can say, active gyroscopic couple, the reactive gyroscopic couple, what he will do, he will move in this direction, they move in a downward direction. So this means that the bow is moving toward the starboard when it is a falling. The bow is moved toward the starboard when it is a falling. When it's rising, the bow is moved toward the starboard. I represent here. Bow toward the, so, and tend to turn toward the bow, tend to turn toward the port left side. Represent, we have to bow falling in which, what happened? Let us see. O, that is the X, is taking the right. So reactive gyroscopic couple is acting in opposite direction to maintain the body in equilibrium condition. So due to this, bow is moved toward the, this bow is moved toward the starboard. So this means that we have to present here this couple with acting here is acting in a, where here, in a horizontal plane, in a horizontal plane. So the bow is tend to turn toward the, well, toward the starboard, and bow turn toward the starboard, that is, we can say as toward right side. Okay, any confusion up to here? I think so, there is no confusion. Again, in this case, we need to find out the gyroscopic couple, we need to find out in the pitching. So how to find out the gyroscopic couple? C is equal to, C equal to I, so I will write here the gyroscopic couple I think so it is not sufficient, so for that reasons I am rubbing this one here. Okay, please take this in snapshot. I'm rubbing this one here. Okay, I rub. Done.
gyroscopic couple C is equal to I into omega into omega P.
The gyroscopic couple should be is equal to the mass moment of inertia of a rotor, and W is angular velocity of a rotor, and omega P is nothing but angular velocity of the precession. Omega P nothing but the angular velocity of precession, nothing but this ship is moving from axis of spin to the axis of precession.
So I, we can say as I formula is m into k square omega. Angular velocity formula is 2 pi n by 60. And omega p,
in the first case, let us read, when the ship pitches with an angular velocity of 1 radian per second. So this means that angular velocity of 1 radian per second, nothing but omega p. Omega p, how much is given? It is given as 1 radian per second. Omega p value is 1 radian per second. Any confusion up to here?
I think so. There's no confusion for you.
Mass. Mass of a motor, how much is given? It is given as 1000 kg. And radius of gyration, how much is given? 300 mm. So this means that we need to convert in meter.
Means 0.3.
Is it right? How? Means K is equal to 300 mm. K is equal to 0.300 meter, we can say. Is it right? I'm substituting here. Whole square. 2 as it is, pi means 3.142. The speed of rotation of the rotor, how much is given? 1550 rpm by 60 into multiply by 1. So if you divide with the help of calci, then you will get the answer is 1468.4 newton meter. So what is the answer is there with the help of calci? 1468.4 newton meter. But if your intention is you want to convert in kilonewton, means you need to remove the 3 digits. So value is 14.6084 into 10 power of 3 newton meter. Answer is 14.6084 kilo newton meter. That is the value of C. Any confusion up to here?
I think so, no confusion.
So first condition is completed. When the ship is pitches with the angular velocity of 1 radian per second, when the bow is rising, that is the first condition. When bow is rising, what happened here? Bow is turned toward the port. So we can say as left hand side. So bow is turned toward the port. When bow is rising, when bow is falling, when bow is moved toward the starboard. So that is the condition is given in the first case. Again, second condition we need to find out is when the ship is speeding at 40 km per hour and take a right turn in a circular path of 200 mm radius. I will rub this one. Please take this snapshot. Second condition we are going to learn.
Second, I will draw the figure of a ship. Okay. The axis we can say as axis of spin, and the vertical we can say as axis of precession. Okay. So if the observer is observed from the bow, okay, let us see.
When the ship is speeding at 40 km per hour, so this means that the ship is moving with a velocity. The velocity is 40 km per hour. The velocity of a ship is 40 km per hour, and take a right turn in a circular path of 200 mm radius. So how it is taken here? It is taking the right path. Is it right? Let us see. That is the left and this is right path. If you observe from here, of radius, how much is there? The radius is 200 mm radius. Okay, dear. Let us see. V equal to 40 km per hour. We need to convert 40 into kilo means 10^3. If you want to convert meter per hour to meter per second, means you need to divide it by 3600 meter per second. It convert in meter per second. That is the value of V. Okay, dear. It is how much is given? 200 mm is given. First thing is, we need to find out the gyroscopic couple. Okay, gyroscopic couple, we need to find out. C is equal to I into omega into omega P of turning a right turn. So I is indicate that the mass moment of inertia of a motor. So motor, how they rotate in here? It rotate in clockwise direction when it is seen from the bow. Okay, and the velocity of moving is 40 km per hour is given. For I, we need to find out, means which formula we are to use here, because mass is given, K also given. Just you need to substitute here, M into K square into omega value is, angular velocity value is 2 pi n by 60. We have the formula. Okay, dear. And angular velocity of precession is V by R. What is the formula? I value formula is mk square, omega value is 2 pi n by 60, omega p, angular velocity of precession value is v by r. Okay, then mass value is how much? The mass of this rotor, it is given as 1000. Radius of gyration is given as 0.3 whole square. 2 pi is constant. N, speed of rotation is 1550 by 60 by V. Velocity, how much is given? 40 into 10^3 by 3600. 40 into 10^3 by 3600 into the radius. How much is given? The radius is given as 200 mm. Then if you are divide this value, then you will get the answer is during the steering. Answer you getting 811.57 Newton meter. That is the value of C. Gyroscopic couple. Then we know very well, if the observer is observed from the bow, we are taking the right turn. If it is taking the right turn, what we can say? It is considered as positive, and the rotor is rotating in clockwise direction,
again it is considered as positive. Rotor is rotating in clockwise direction is considered as positive.
Positive into positive, it should be positive. So this means that the gyroscopic coupled direction will be raise the bow and lower the stern. What will be the effect?
The effect
on the ship is raise the
bow and lower the stern. Lower the stern.
Then you need to draw the figure. Let us see. Okay, raise the bow
and lower the stern.
Okay, any confusion up to here? I think so, there is no confusion for you. I will go for third condition. Okay dear, I will drop this one. Please take this snapshot. In case of rolling, third condition is rolling. Okay, yeah. Let us see. First, I will draw the figure. The horizontal axis we can say as axis of spin, and this vertical axis we known as axis of precision. Let us see, the first thing is we need to find out the gyroscopic couple. Gyroscopic couple we need to find out
in the rolling. Gyroscopic effect we need to find out.
What is the formula? Same formula we have to use. C is equal to I into omega P. Okay dear, then I value is mass moment of inertia is m into k square. The angular velocity is how much is given? 2 pi n by 60. And angular velocity of precession how much is given? It is given as 0.5 radius per second. 0.5. Is it right? Mass is given as 1000 kg. Radius of gyration is 0.3 whole square, 2 into 3.142. Speed of rotation is 1550 by 60 into 0.5. So if you multiply with the help of calci, then you will get the answer is 7304.2 Newton meter. If you want to convert in
किलोन्यूटन मीन्स 7.3042 किलोन्यूटन मीटर. सी इज इक्वल टू 7.3042 किलोन्यूटन मीटर. बट
व्हाट विल बी द इफेक्ट ड्यूरिंग द रोलिंग? Always we know very well the gyroscopic effect will be present if axis of precision should be, listen here, axis of precision should be perpendicular to the axis of spin. But in the rolling, the axis of precision is parallel to the axis of spin. So this means that in such type of the case, there is no gyroscopic effect is acting on the during the rolling operation. Then we can represent here. Again I will repeat for the better understanding purpose. If the gyroscopic effect will be present if the axis of precision is perpendicular to the axis of spin. But in the case of rolling, axis of precision should be parallel to axis of spin. Hence, there is no gyroscopic effect is acting during the rolling operation. Okay, I will write here. Effect gyroscopic will be present if the axis of precision should be perpendicular to the axis of spin. Axis of precision should be perpendicular to the axis of spin. So in case of rolling, the axis of precision should be parallel to the axis of spin. Axis of spin. Hence, no gyroscopic effect on the ship during rolling. Okay dear, if you have any doubt regarding this class, please write down in the comment box. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.